Hey everybody, Adventurous Gardener here. It's a beautiful day.
I had gathered a bunch of rocks from a neighboring property because I intended to build our waterfall into more of a cascading set of falls instead of just an abrupt drop off. Well, I started to build that. We're in the shop here. We're gonna grab our hydraulic water stop cement by Quikrete. And where's our little trowel? Okay, perfect. To avoid getting scolded and ruining more of our good dishes, I'm gonna use an empty kitty litter container that was out for recycling to mix my concrete in. So my initial spillway design was a pressurized filter with an aluminum dustpan. Yes, an aluminum dustpan, which used to abruptly toss water out onto this flat stone and then down into the pond. Here is the new weir. We're just gonna go ahead and slide that in place down here where it goes. Hopefully nothing has shifted over the winter thus far. There we go. Perfect.
Okay, once we've got our mud to the consistency that we're looking for, like I said, we want it to be firm enough to stay in the cracks on a vertical surface here. I like it to be something like that. Just go ahead and start troweling it in. Places where it needs to be. As it firms up here, I just want to smooth it out a bit by hand and make it conform to the natural curvature of the stones.
That was a fiasco. I dropped the trowel in there. My boot went underwater, got soaked. Got a cheap old plastic bristle brush here. The bristles are nice and firm, so I'm gonna work this a little bit and show you. And I want to add some texture back into this. I'm just gonna use the top of the brush and I'm just gonna dab. And we're gonna get a stone texture back into the concrete. It'll give the algae places to grab onto and to live. I'm just trying to imitate stone here.
Time to mix up some more mud.
Our second batch here going on. Get some water into our bucket.
We've got everything all sealed up as far as I can tell. We're gonna let that dry.
What was I just saying about having a snowless February? I'm gonna take you over here for a second. You may be wondering what on earth happened there. Well, now you can see I used plastic pallets underneath the pond here, which is how I made that stacked rock structure underwater for the fish to go underneath. That's their, you know, hibernating and breeding habitat. So the pipe broke, leading from the pump to the filter. The piping tends to get brittle over time, and I could probably snap it easily just, you know, whoops, there you go, just bending it. So, definitely time for a new one. Cool, the new corrugated tubing has arrived. We're running a 1.5 inch inner diameter from our Creekstone / Harbor Freight 4,500 gallon per hour submersible water pump through the corrugated line up to our new weir box. Now, as you saw, the other piece snapped from being brittle due to UV degradation as well as hot and cold temperature cycling. This is a maintenance item, but I got 8 years out of the last one, so well worth the $40 I spent. And if you use a coupon code, you can get a waterfall pump like that for a really great price as well. Again, 7 or 8 seasons on that, and I can't complain. I didn't know what to expect, but I am happy with the results. I have a multi-tiered waterfall now, and put a little bit of pondzyme in there by API. That's gonna eat some of the sludge that formed over the bottom over the winter. So this is the new waterfall.
Friends, thank you as always for spending time with me. Click the thumbs up button to show me some love. Press subscribe to show your support. If you have any questions or comments, I'd love to hear from you. Go ahead and drop them down below. For now, enjoy the sunset. Until next time.